Simon Sinek's got a clear message, and that is what and how show up when there is clarity about the reason you're doing what you're doing. If it's purely a money thing, what you will find is it's not long-term sustainable. Let me tell you my why. I'm past the stage, like, with money, I have enough. I'm not, like, a billionaire, but there is no way that I'm risking anything now because I have enough. So I need to have compelling reasons to actually work, to get out of bed. My why is to reduce suffering of people in the real estate industry. I get a kick out of knowing that there are people that have been shit at school, that have had dark pasts, that have never had a good opportunity to get ahead in life. They get into real estate, and I have the ability now with technology to impact a lot of people. So I have a very, very strong value of easing suffering and helping people. That's my why. So that drives me. And Susan, and I was saying to Sam, everyone needs to have a Susan in their business. What do I mean by a Susan? Someone in your business that treats your business like it's their business, but it's not their business. Everyone needs one of those in their business. Everyone needs a person that treats the business like it's their business, even though it's not their business. They become a low-skilled stunt double of you. So a lot of people say, but that's impossible. Why would you actually have someone like that? Why would they be there if it's not their business? Well, what you've got to do is you've got to look for their why. You've got to try and work out, does my business provide them an opportunity for them to fulfill their why? And, you know, whether it's flexible hours, whether it's allowing them to actually double down on their strengths and do stuff that they're good at, you can find that there's a lot of people that money is not number one on their list. Let me tell you, for Susan, obsessed with yoga, obsessed with veganism, obsessed with being able to work, she is on the, and this is another issue, people are born either as morning people or as night people. Some people have this ability where they do most of their creative and hard work mornings. Other people are actually, people can be sitting at 9, 10, 11, 12 o'clock. It is got to do with their chemistry, their melatonin, right, that affects their sleep patterns. They operate differently. If you can actually work with people that allows them to be at their best health being, that helps. So she's a classic example. She wakes up at 10 o'clock, but I'm getting content being done between 11 o'clock p.m. at night and 1 o'clock, you know, and I'm quite different. I wake up at 5 o'clock, 5:15, 5:30.